Good morning, YouTube. Today we're going to be making a heated cabinet to keep my welding electrodes in. 7018 electrodes are a low hydrogen electrode. If they have been stored out of heat, then they need to be baked. I think it's at 400 degrees for a half an hour to drive any water vapor and hydrogen out of the flux, and then they need to be stored at about 40 degrees. So we've already gutted this old microwave, and we're going to be putting in a thermostat and a light bulb and a kill switch to turn the light bulb off when the door is opened. And because the inside of this particular microwave is only 13 and 3/4 inches long, and the box of 7018 electrodes is 14 and a half inches long, we have to take out this side. So now we're gonna set you up for a top-down view and hope this thing runs properly, because I won't be able to see what's on the camera once it's up there. If it bends out of focus, then sorry, that's what you got. Anyway, we'll pause it now, or stop it now, and
down to shame. Reckless and my, that is my name.
Okay, so for a couple of hours of work, we have a cabinet that will maintain 80 degrees Fahrenheit, which should keep the welding rods dry once they are dried. The light will shut off when you open the door. The light shuts off with the thermostat at 80 degrees. There is a fuse. And there's screws all over the place. There we go. There is room for 9 boxes of rod in there, approximately. So, a rod warming oven is worth, at Princess, I think it's about $250. So at Harbor Freight, probably in around the $120 range, and it cost me nothing other than a little bit of time. That's it for now. Thanks for watching.